Hi students, welcome to today's lecture on data structures. In our previous class, we have discussed about two searching algorithms. One is linear search and the other one is binary search. And also, we have seen some examples to understand the process of linear search and binary search. And then we analyzed the time complexity of linear search and binary search in terms of best case, average case, and worst case. Today, we will focus on Fibonacci search. Right? Okay. So before we begin our Fibonacci search algorithm, let us recap a few things, because Fibonacci search is also a solution for searching problem. Let us define the searching problem first. Searching is the process of finding some element, let us say key, in a given list of elements. Okay, so you will be given a list of elements and also a key for searching. You need to search for that key in the given list. If the key is present in the corresponding list, then it will be considered as a successful search. In that case, you need to return the index of the corresponding element. If the key is not present in the corresponding list, then it becomes unsuccessful search, then you will be returning a minus one. Okay, so this is how searching works, right? So for that purpose, we have seen two algorithms in our previous class. One is linear search and the other one is binary search. Linear search is a sequential search which searches for the key by comparing each element starting from the leftmost element of the list, moving towards rightmost element of the list. Okay, so if the element is found, it returns the index, otherwise it returns minus one. So if you look at the time complexity of linear search, in best case, that is if the element is present in the first position itself, then the time complexity is big O of one, because only one comparison is required. In case of the element is not present in the first position, then the time complexities are going to be order of n. We saw this in our previous class. And for binary search, if the element is present exactly at the middle of element, then the best case time complexity is big O of 1. In the remaining two cases, the time complexity is going to be big O of log n. So let us begin our Fibonacci search. The first thing you need to understand is Fibonacci search is an extension to your binary search algorithm. Therefore, it also follows the same rules followed by the binary search for dividing the corresponding list into sublists. But the only difference is binary search divides the entire list into two halves exactly, whereas Fibonacci search divides the corresponding list into unequal subarrays or unequal sublists based on the Fibonacci numbers, right? But Fibonacci search also follows the same policy, divide and conquer methodology, solving the solution. But instead of dividing the array into two equal subarrays, it divides the array into unequal subarrays with the help of Fibonacci numbers. So because Fibonacci search depends on the Fibonacci numbers, let us understand what are Fibonacci numbers first. You might have read these Fibonacci numbers in your first year. Anyhow, I'll repeat that topic again, how the Fibonacci numbers will be calculated. So we can define the Fibonacci number sequence recursively by using these formulas. F of 0 is equal to 0, which means that the first element in the sequence is 0. F of 1 is equal to 1. That means the second element in the sequence is 1. And the remaining elements in the sequence, F of n, are calculated as a sum of the previous two elements in the sequence. That is F of n minus 1 plus F of n minus 2. Okay, so I repeat, the first element in the Fibonacci sequence is 0. The second element in the Fibonacci sequence is 1, and the remaining elements in the Fibonacci sequence are calculated by adding up the previous two numbers of the sequence. Okay, so let us have a look at this Fibonacci sequence. The first number is 0, there is no calculation over here, it is fixed. The second number is 1, it is also fixed. These two numbers are fixed. And from then onwards, the third number is sum of the previous two numbers, that is 0 plus 1. And the fourth number is sum of the previous two numbers, that is 1 plus 1. And fifth number is sum of the previous two numbers, that is 1 plus 2. And so on. 2 plus 3 is 5. 3 plus 5 is 8. 5 plus 8 is 13. And so on. These are called as Fibonacci numbers that forms a Fibonacci sequence. Goes on. You can calculate infinite number of Fibonacci elements in the sequence. Okay. Our Fibonacci search algorithm uses these Fibonacci numbers for partitioning the array into subarrays. Okay. Let us see how it works. So this is the algorithm for searching an element x in a given array of elements arr of 0 to n minus 1. So the indexes are starting from 0 to n minus 1, which means there are n elements in the array arr. Arr is the name of the array. Okay. So let arr of 0 comma n minus 1 be the input array, and the element that we are searching for is x. Okay. Now the algorithm says that the first thing you need to do is find the smallest Fibonacci number greater than or equal to n. You have to read this very carefully because it is a bit confusing thing. Find the smallest Fibonacci number greater than or equal to n. What is n? N is the size of the array. Okay. So you need to find out a Fibonacci number which is greater than this n. But among all those greater values than this n, you pick the smallest Fibonacci number. That means this sentence says that you pick the first Fibonacci number which is greater than or equal to n. That is the meaning. Even though it is written as smallest Fibonacci number greater than, the meaning is pick the first Fibonacci number which is greater than or equal to. Okay, in the sequence itself, from the sequence, you need to pick that value. Right. So let us say the value that we pick is fib m, which is located at mth position. So fib m is the mth Fibonacci number. We assume that this is the Fibonacci number that is greater than or equal to n. Okay, so fib m is the smallest Fibonacci number greater than or equal to n. We assume like that. And then once you identify this, you need to identify two more Fibonacci numbers which are just before this number, the lesser Fibonacci numbers than this. That means Fibonacci number m minus 1, that is m minus 1 Fibonacci number, and Fibonacci number minus 2, m2, fib m, m2, that is m minus 2 Fibonacci number. Simply saying, this is the smallest Fibonacci number which is greater than or equal to n, and this is the Fibonacci number which is just before this Fibonacci number, and this is the second least element from this fib m. Okay, so the previous two numbers of fib m are considered as fib m m1 and fib m m2. Okay, so this is the first task that we need to do. What is it? Find a Fibonacci number which is greater than or equal to n, where n is the size of the array, and then the two elements which are in the sequence before that Fibonacci number are also considered as fib mm1 and fib mm2. Right. So after doing this step, the actual algorithm begins over here. We will consider the offset value as 0. We initialize, this is just a variable we consider for calculating the offsets. So initially we put a value 0 into this offset, and then while the array has elements to be inspected, at the beginning there are no elements, the inspection is not yet started, so every element needs to be inspected. And then while the array has elements to be inspected, we perform all these steps. Okay, right. So what are those steps that will be repeated over here? The first step is we will calculate the index value for comparison by using this formula. The formula is I is equal to min of offset plus fib mm2 comma n minus 1. n minus 1 is the last index in the array, and this is the index value we are calculating. This minNaF assures that the value which we are calculating should not go beyond the array. Okay, so that is why we consider minNaF of set plus fibm m2. This is the index we are calculating, and comma n minus 1. Whichever is minimum, it will be considered as index. If this calculation goes beyond the index of the array, the last index of the array, then n minus 1 will be considered, so that there is an element. Okay, right. So after calculating this index I, we compare the value x with the element at I. Okay, what is this x? X is the element for which we are searching. Okay, we compare it with the element at I in the array. If x matches, then return the corresponding index I. Because we found the element, so index I will be returned. If x does not match, then we need to perform two more comparisons here. If x is less than the element, then move the three Fibonacci variables. What are the three Fibonacci variables? Fibmm, Fibmm1, Fibmm2. All those Fibonacci variables will be moved two Fibonacci values down. Okay, so you will understand this two Fibonacci down when we consider the example later. Okay, the thing you need to remember is the variables Fibmm1, Fibmm2 are moved backwards two positions. Okay, two positions will be moved backwards, all these three values, right? When it is done, when the three variables are moved backwards, two Fibonacci values down, if x is less than the element. Okay, otherwise, if x is greater than the element, then what will happen is, we will do the same thing, move the three Fibonacci variables again, one Fibonacci value down, not the two Fibonacci values down. So if x is less than the element, we will move the Fibonacci variables to two Fibonacci values down. And if x is greater than the element, then we move the three Fibonacci variables, one Fibonacci value down. And also in this case, we perform one more thing. We will reset the offset value to I. The offset value is updated. If x is less than the element, we need to observe that offset is not updated. Whatever offset value is there in the previous step, it will be considered. But now it is updated to I. Offset is updated to I. Okay. So these steps will be repeated until the array has elements to be inspected. So when it has, because we are checking the x value, we are comparing the x value with the element at I, and I is calculated as the value at fibmm2. So whenever the array goes beyond this fibmm2, that means the lower bound is crossed by fibmm2, then this will be stopped. Okay, because fibmm2 is out of the array bounds, there is no element to search, then this array will be, loop will be stopped. Okay, so when the loop stops, it comes over here. Observe this carefully, what it is saying. So if fibmm2 goes beyond the lower bound of the array, then the possibility is fibmm1 and fibmm2 will be at 1. Okay, so both will be pointing at 1, right? And if that is the case, what we will do is, because there is only one element left, we compare that element with x, and if it matches, then we return the corresponding index. If it does not match, we say that the element is not present in the array. Okay, so this loop assures that all the elements are tested except that first element, that is first element, and we compare that remaining element over here to identify that whether that remaining single element is the element that we are searching for. If it matches, we return the index. Otherwise, we return minus one. Okay. Now let us understand this example, this algorithm with an example. Say I am considering an array with 11 elements. So I am considering an array with 11 elements. I assume that the index begins at 1 and ends at 11. Okay. So the array is with n is equal to 11 elements. So what is our first step? The first step says that find the smallest Fibonacci number which is greater than or equal to n. So what is n here? N is 11. So we look for an element which is greater than 11 in the Fibonacci sequence. So let us write the Fibonacci sequence starting with 0. So 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21. Because we found an element which is greater than n here in the Fibonacci sequence, we stop there. So this is going to be FibM, and this is FibMM1, and this is FibMM2. M1, M2 stands for minus 1, FibM minus 1, and FibM minus 2. So FibM is 13 here, FibMM1 is 8, FibMM2 is 5. So that is our first step. We did it. Okay. Now, what this second step is saying, initialize the offset value to 0. Okay, it is done. While the array has elements to be inspected, yes, till now, every element needs to be inspected. So what is it saying? Repeat all these steps until there are no elements for inspection in the array. What is that step saying? Calculate the index value by using the formula min of offset plus fibmm2 comma n minus 1. In this algorithm, we wrote it as n minus 1, but because we considered 1 to 11, we consider it as n only. Okay? We consider it as n only because 0 to n minus 1, but it is index is starting at 1, therefore the index ends with the n. Okay? So now let us understand this process. So in first iteration, if you look at this, these are the three values we initialized. Fibm is 13. FibMM1 is 8, FibMM2 is 5. And in the array, let us say I want to search for 85. Okay, is it there in the array? Yes, it is there. The array is containing the element 85, which is located at 9. Right. Now, so what it is saying? Initially, offset is 0, so we did that. Now, calculate this index by using the formula minimum of offset plus FibMM2, this one, this is actually FibL, the lowest Fib value, that is nothing but FibMM2, comma N. What is N? 11. So, offset is 0 plus FibMM2 is 5, 0 plus 5. Okay, so in this case, 5 comma 11. So, which one is minimum? 5. 5 is minimum, so I is calculated as 5. And then what we do is consider the value at ARR of 5. What is the value at ARR of 5? If you look at it, it is 45, right? So now we compare the X value, that is 85, with this 45. What it is saying, X is what? Greater than this 45. X is greater than this. They are not same. If they are same, then the index will be returned. Because they are not same, we will verify that what is the relationship with X. So you see that X is greater than this 45. So what the algorithm is saying now, if X is greater than the element, then move the three Fibonacci values, one Fibonacci down. Okay, and reset the offset value to I. Okay, we'll do that. Okay, so let us move these Fibonacci values one backwards. What is the one backward value of 13? It is 8. So 13 is replaced with 8. And what is the one backward value of 8 in the Fibonacci sequence? 5. So this 8 will be replaced by 5. And what is the one backward value of 5? It is 3, right? If you look at the sequence, you will find that it is 3. Okay, so this 5 is replaced with 3. So all these Fibonacci values, the 3 Fibonacci values are moved one down. So that's what it is saying. Move one down and then reset offset. Offset is now reset to the index value, previous value of index. It is 5. Okay, so now again we are going to do the same task. What is it? Calculate I. How do you calculate I? Offset plus fibl. Offset, what is offset here? 5 plus fibmm 2, that is 8, comma n is 11. So 8 comma 11, minimum is 8. So we consider 8. And what is the element at 8 in the array? If you look at the array, element at 8 is 82. Okay, so it is 82. Again, we compare. Is the value x same as this element? No. Then what is the relationship? X is greater than 82. Therefore, the same condition is met compared with the previous step. Same condition is met. So what we do? Move one down and reset offset. Move one down. That is, 8 is set as 5. 5 is set as 3. And 3 is set as 2. One down. One down in the Fibonacci sequence. Okay. And this offset is reset to the index value. Previous index, 8. Okay. Again, we will calculate I value at this level. I value is calculated as offset plus the fibmm2, the minimum, the least fib value. That is 8 plus 2 is 10. And minimum of 10 comma 11 is 10. Okay. And the element at location 10 is 90. If you observe that the value at 10 is 90, so we consider that element. Again, we compare. Are they same? No. 85 is different from 90. Then what is the relationship? X is less than this 90. So what we do, if X is less than element, what it is saying, if X is less than the element, then move the 3 Fibonacci variables, 2 Fibonacci values down. Okay, move 2 down at this case. So what we do, 5 is moved 2 values down. 1 value down is 3, 2 values down is 2, this one. So 5 is changed to 2. And for 3, 1 value down is 2, 2 values down is 1, the previous value. So it is 1. And for 2, 1 value down is 1, 2 values down is also 1. Right? So the previous 2 values of 2 is 1, 1 only. Therefore, it is 1. And if you observe, the offset is not reset to the previous index. It is same as the previous offset. Right? It is not reset to the index. The offset value is considered same as the previous step. Okay? Again, we calculate the index value by using the same formula. Offset plus the least value of Fibonacci index. That is 1. 8 plus 1 is 9. 9 comma 11, minimum value is 9, therefore we consider 9. And if you look at the element at 9th position, it is 85, and we consider it 85 over here. Compare this with 85, both are same, therefore we return the index 9. Where it is found at 9. Okay, so this is how the Fibonacci search algorithm works. And my request is, all of you try to solve this problem for different key values. So we did this with 85 as key value, and let us say you search for 35, and also you search for some 90, and you search for some 25, and change that key value and try to evaluate your algorithm so that you will get a clear picture about how this algorithm works. Okay, so that is how the Fibonacci search works. Okay, now let us compare this Fibonacci search with the binary search algorithm. If you observe the similarities, both the binary search algorithm and Fibonacci search algorithm works for sorted arrays only. They cannot be used on unsorted arrays. That is the first point you need to understand. And also, both binary search and Fibonacci search uses the same methodology, algorithm methodology, which is divide and conquer algorithm. Okay, because both of them is splitting the array into subarrays. Maybe in binary search, the array is exactly divided into two halves, whereas in Fibonacci search, the array is divided into unequal arrays, the subarrays. That is the difference. But this also follows divide and conquer approach only. And coming to the time complexity, the binary search has the time complexity in average case and worst case, big O of log n. And Fibonacci search also has a big O of log n time complexity in average case and worst case. And in best case, the time complexity of binary search is big O of 1 if the element is exactly found at middle. And the Fibonacci search best case time complexity is also big O of 1 if the element is directly found at the first index that we calculate. Okay. So therefore, these three are the similarities of Fibonacci search algorithm with the binary search. Now, if you see the differences of Fibonacci search algorithm with binary search algorithm, the first difference, as I said, Fibonacci search divides given array in unequal parts, whereas binary search uses division operation exactly at the middle. Okay, exactly at the middle, right? And the second difference is Fibonacci search does not use the division operation. If you observe the operations over there in the algorithm, if you observe that operations, see, there is no division operation. It is dividing it, but it's not using the division operation. It is using addition operation and subtraction operation, moving one down, two down. Addition and subtraction operations, as you know, requires very less CPU time for execution, whereas division operation requires more CPU time while executing your algorithm. So in that words, Fibonacci search requires less time compared with binary search, because binary search involves division operation for calculating the middle element. If you recollect that formula for calculating the middle element, mid is equal to low plus high by 2. So there is a division operation involved. Whereas in Fibonacci search, there is no division operation. We use offset plus the least Fibonacci value. We use plus only. And based on the conditions, we go down two Fibonacci values, that is subtraction operation. So Fibonacci search is entirely basing on these two operations. It's not using any division operations. Therefore, the cost of the operations in Fibonacci search is less compared with the binary search. Okay. With this, the Fibonacci search algorithm is completed. I request all of you to go through the algorithm again and again until you understand this algorithm, because it is actually not so easy to remember this algorithm. If you practice this algorithm many times, then you can remember. The better approach is use this example to practice the steps in the algorithm, and then you can write this algorithm in your own words also by remembering the steps you are doing over there. Okay, so that is my suggestion. I hope you understood this algorithm. If you do not understand this algorithm, please practice it again to understand it properly. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you. We'll see you again in the Monday's class. Thank you.